This is your daily recap presented by GMC with Jamie Eisenberg and Brady Quinn. I'm Chris Hassel, and for both these teams, the preparation now is pretty much done with. The practices are over. The media obligations are over. Less than 48 hours now until they kick on Sunday.
This is their last opportunity really to go over the game plan and make some additions potentially. We saw that in the AFC Championship game with Josh McDaniels and the New England Patriots putting in 7 or 8 plays the day of the game, or deleting some things, taking out some things that maybe you don't feel comfortable with as a player, could be a quarterback, or even the coach. He has some reps over the past 2 weeks and hasn't looked good. So this is the last opportunity to have those conversations before you go into the game. And really the old school way, as far as practice goes, it used to be a walkthrough the day before the game. Nowadays, teams like to actually have more of an up-tempo, abbreviated practice where they start to prime themselves for that next day for game day. So it'll be interesting to see, you know, how the team, how each of these teams kind of operate, which schedule they go off of, how it impacts them moving forward on Sunday.
I'm tired of talking about it. Let's just see the game play. Aaron Donald versus Brady and the Patriots defensive, you know, offensive line in the defensive front. Brady and what he's going to do against this team. Is this going to be Gronk's last game? Is this run game going to be good for the Patriots? Is Todd Gurley's knee all right? Let's just play the game already. It's time. Stop the talking. Let's just go.
One thing as the week's gone on that's become pretty apparent, in particular here on Radio Row, is this. A lot of Patriots fans. Not seeing many Rams fans. And what does
that
mean?
Point.
What does that mean? The Patriots then have the opportunity to use their cadence. And why is that important? Now I've gotten in my toolbox the ability to try to draw off Aaron Donald or Ndamukong Suh and use my cadence in an environment that's supposed to be neutral. But it won't be in this case. I think it's going to be more like a home crowd or home game for the Patriots. And on the flip side, that means Jared Goff probably has to use more silent count. That plays to the advantage of the Patriots defensive front, Trey Flowers rushing the passer. That's the type of environment I think we're going to have in this game.
You don't think that even with the national team being the LA Rams, as far as the team that we're rooting for, that a lot of people are rooting for because they're tired of the Patriots, those neutral fans are going to get on their side?
I don't think so. I think it's more of a corporate event at the Super Bowl anyway. Yeah. And I think you're going to see a fair amount of fans travel for one side or the other. We're not seeing a lot of LA fans. I could be wrong. Maybe they'll get in town.
I've seen more
tomorrow.
Chiefs fans than Rams fans here.
Right. And maybe that had more to do with it. We saw Tyreek Hill. We saw Travis Kelce, Patrick Mahomes today. Maybe it had to do with more of that.
Yeah.
But bottom line is, I think we're going to see a lot more Patriots fans and hear them louder come game time.
If I hear Pete Prisco say wham one more time, I'm going to vomit. So let's just get the game played early.
We move out of here, and tomorrow we're going to be over at the fan experience on Saturday. And then Sunday, it's game time.
Game time.
We got to see a lot of superstars today. Brady, though, ran into the Backstreet Boys.
I did.
He said that.
Literally.
What was it you said? You picked one of them up and set them aside
to
get out of
I happened to walk through a crowd, and I didn't realize I was walking right into a camera shot for them. And I was trying to move one of them out of the way. I didn't realize it was a Backstreet Boy himself. He was kind of tiny, and I turned around and said, hey.
Up, right? They're not just little kids anymore.
No, he's still pretty tiny. Right? I said, hey, big fan, nice to meet you. I was like, sorry about that. And I went on with my day.
I like that you went, you were like, I did this. Not like I did this. I picked him up, put him over here to walk past. Backstreet Boys here. Everybody
they're
here.
Back.
We're not seeing any of the players that you'll see on Sunday, though. They're locked away for the next 48 hours until we see them on Sunday. That's it from here for now. We send it back up to Stamford, Connecticut.